Dört mezhepte, Sünni mezheplerde, Hanefi,
the coming of Hazreti Mehdi aleyhisselam and the descent of the Prophet Jesus aleyhisselam is a matter of certainty in all four Sunni schools, the Hanefi, Hanbali, Maliki and Shafi. His descent is of certain decree. That is also the case in the Ja'fari school and with the Shiites, Alawites and all of them. There is full agreement among them all. There are two great denominations in Islam, Sunni and Shiite. These make up 90% or more of the Islamic world. They all agree on the coming of Hazrat Mehdi a.s. and the descent of Prophet Jesus a.s. That means there is no room for doubt on the subject. Of course, there are many verses on this in the Quran. It's also described in detail in the Al-Kutub Al-Sitta, six books, which, as you know, is a completely trustworthy work. For example, the coming of Jesus, son of Maryam, is related in Bukhari's 118th hadith. I swear to Allah who holds my breath in his hand that Jesus, son of Maryam, will descend among you as a just judge. He will break the cross and slay the pig, and he will abolish the tax on non-Muslims. Goods will be so plentiful that nobody will want any more, and a single prostration in prayer is more valuable than the world and everything in it. He says that prostration, prayer in other words, is a very great blessing. Hadith 119 reads, "What will become of you when Jesus, son of Maryam, descends among you and abides by your imam, even though your imam, your head of state is one of you?" There are many more instances. In the 37th hadith of Al-Bukhari, doomsday will not take place until Jesus, son of Maryam, descends among you as a just ruler, smashes the cross, slays the pig, and abolished the capitation tax on non-Muslims, and until there are so many goods around that nobody wants anymore. That's from Bukhari, though it is in all of them, Bukhari, Muslim, Tirmidhi, and Ibn Majah. There are some 20 references to world dominion in the Quran.